It was a morning to remember here at the Florissant Valley campus of the St. Louis Community College. The ribbon was officially cut on the new Advanced Manufacturing Center here. This $51.8 million facility is set to provide crucial job training for years to come. Take a look at the big moment now when the ribbon was cut. Many dignitaries were here, including Missouri Governor Mike Kehoe and St. Louis County Executive Sam Page. This center has been under construction since August of 2023. Leaders say it will help prepare students for careers in manufacturing, engineering, technology, and the technical trades. There are multiple hands-on training labs in this new facility for fields like HVAC, welding, electronics, and biomedical equipment repair. There is also a specific part of this building to train students for jobs with Boeing in the area of sheet metal and composites. The facility here is one of six new buildings on the four St. Louis Community College campuses to open this year as a result of Proposition R. That was an 8-cent tax increase for STLCC campus upgrades approved by voters back in 2021. We spoke with Governor Kehoe about the importance of this center.
It's a game changer for our state because as we talk to economic development opportunities, whether to expand or consider moving to Missouri and certainly the St. Louis region, being able to provide a skilled workforce is what companies are looking for. This is the physical brick and mortar experience that students can go through that guarantees them a future of success, a future of hope, a future of opportunity. I love this project. I love what we're doing around the state with similar efforts. And I don't think we can invest enough in our young generation to get them ready for the future workforce.
Proposition R is funding a total of $450 million in improvements to the St. Louis Community College campuses. It's known as the STLCC Transformed Project. We will see what this center can deliver for our community in the future. For now, reporting in Ferguson, Chris Renier, Fox News.